Denver Broncos Mile High View. No commercials, no bullshit. Well, I go out to sea and come back, and everything happened the way I said it would. The Broncos would have to go toe-to-toe with Green Bay. Obviously, fail. That was not going to happen. Coming up with the Jaguars, it's not going to be an easy game. If you are a Bronco fan thinking that this is the easy game, that you're, this is the game that, you know, that you're supposed to win, I got a little news for you. If you followed my podcasts, you know what when I talk about backup quarterbacks, how important they are. You're getting a backup quarterback that's really, really sharp. Here's the thing. I want to talk about, before I get into the Jags and what I saw in Green Bay, I'm trying to do some catch up here, trying to make this brief as always, I'm really getting sick and tired that the people that fed us the Kool-Aid, you know, the 10-6, 12-4, fifth best defense, all this garbage, when I was the lone voice out there saying the Lions cannot produce that kind of a winning record. And then looking at so many things with the Denver Broncos right now, I'm getting sick and tired that the people that were serving the Kool-Aid are talking fire sale now, fire sale, because they didn't see what was coming. I saw what was coming. Am I panicked? No. You know, you have to stay calm to correct the problem, but of course they won't do that. So you're going to hear about fire sales, and they're running around, oh, my God, four losses. Oh. Yeah, you have four losses. And let me tell you why you probably will have four losses. You have no lines, none. Plus, the coaching, especially defensively, is subpar, okay? The blitzes seem to be okay when you're not, like, jumping off sides. Coverage, I said Kareem Jackson was not a cover guy. If you go back and look, you'll see Kareem Jackson is not a cover guy. This is why I wanted to bring in Greedy Williams. He is a true cover guy, and that's what the Broncos need. What Kareem Jackson does, he clogs the middle. He's supposed to take care of the tight ends. So why is the defense having him chasing down defenders into the end zone, you know, two steps, three steps behind? So, by the way, Aaron Rodgers gets free plays, you know, this kind of thing. Okay, you got Jacksonville coming up. Here's the thing, Denver Bronco fans. Here's the thing. You want to really understand how to fix the Denver Broncos problems? You want to understand how to do that? It's not fire sales. Rookies in the draft aren't going to help you out. You got to start building up the lines. That's what you have to do. You have to start building up the lines. I'm watching the highlights of both Green Bay and Denver. I'm looking at the highlights of Tennessee and Jacksonville. And let me tell you, Jacksonville has a couple of things that I brought up working for them. I keep trying to pound this into Bronco fans' heads that are quarterback obsessed. It's got to be Lock. Locke can't do anything right now. First of all, let's just get this in perspective. The Jaguars have a stout offensive line. So this quarterback, which is a backup quarterback who's posting, he's one of the top quarterbacks right now in the NFL in quarterback rating. I don't care who the guy, but he's not known. He's got a mustache. That's all we know. And look at Daniel Jones. He wasn't hyped. You know, you got to get off the hype wagon. It starts with the line. The reason why their backup quarterback in Jacksonville is so successful, he has a stout offensive line in front of him. He can trust that offensive line. He isn't worried about when the ball gets hiked. I saw the strip sack of Flacco. That line collapsed so fast. You could see it in all the Green Bay highlights. It was just the collapse of the offensive line over and over and over again. My opinion is, if you want to really rebuild the Broncos, it isn't about fire sales. I would say that you probably get rid of almost everybody on the offensive line. Maybe Reisner is about what you keep. But everybody else has got to go. There is nothing on that offensive line. It looked just like it did with Trevor Siemian. I mean, the ball gets snapped, they're already in the backfield. I mean, that fast. And that's something you can blame John Elway for. So it's going to be very tough for this defense. And let me talk about defensive play calling here for a minute. The thing is on the defensive side of the ball, Fangio knows that there is nobody up front that can push that pocket, that can push that pocket back into the quarterback's face. So what is he doing? He's dropping like every three man rushes, which aren't working. Chubb is double teamed, and Von Miller's double teamed. It's no problem. They can't, you know, it's just stupid. And the thing is that you can't ask the secondary to be covering when Aaron Rodgers has all day to throw the football. It's just, or any quarterback, forget Aaron Rodgers, any quarterback. So instead of fire sales, why can't we start working on, you know, maybe starting to get build up these lines? If you want to blame Elway for anything, is 5 years of crap lines. Everybody wants this, everybody wants that, but the foundation starts at the lines. Jacksonville has both a stout offensive line. They have good defensive linemen. This is going to be a very difficult game for the Broncos. Here's the other thing, too. I've noticed with Green Bay, they know that the Broncos have a weak offensive line. I think it was 6 sacks. And you know, yes, Flacco holds on to the ball too long. Probably half of those are his fault. Absolutely. But this offensive line is so weak, you know, he has to get rid of the ball every time. He cannot hold on to the ball. Every team is coming and bringing everybody because they know that that offensive line just isn't going to hold. So, you know, that could haunt a team if they're smart with it. But, you know, the play calling hasn't been that great. You know, they have to go around. They're only as strong as their weakest link, which is the offensive line. Defensively, Fangio knows the defensive line can't do its job either. Number 15 for the Jaguars is a pretty accurate quarterback, and that's all you need in the league is quick throws, accurate throws. But his line's giving him time. So this very well could be the fourth Bronco loss because just the fact is, if you keep watching these games, you'll see both lines for the Broncos, defensive and offensive, they just get pushed around. You can never win football games when your lines are getting pushed around. I'll keep saying this. You know, fire sales aren't going to help you. You know, building these lines is where the key is. Trust me on that.